How do you keep 90,000 kids in school when physical school is closed? Remote learning is so new, schools are still trying to figure out how to keep track of kids and their effort.
Green engagement means that a student has completed a learning task, and that can be an online discussion or attending a virtual meeting or, you know, doing a project.
Teachers work in teams to look at which students have engaged in every assignment.
Most DPS kids have engaged online, about 87%, according to a month's worth of data obtained and analyzed by 9 Wants to Know. But there's too many missing, and they are important. Kids who've completely stopped learning since school went online. Kids who've never logged on.
Can we put an exact number on those students on a central level? Not quite yet.
Not only are the kids missing, but the data to quantify them is missing too.
Approximate number would be even, I think, tougher and would show an even less accurate picture because we know that we still don't have accurate data from all of our schools.
School district spokesperson Winna McLaren wouldn't even give an estimate.
It really comes down to the fact that this is brand new for everybody. And so we're really exercising patience with our schools and with their teachers as they are trying to do their best in sort of tracking attendance.
District data we've looked at, which is incomplete because it doesn't include charter schools, indicates between 12 and 25% of DPS kids are missing. Schools are tracking online attendance. Some report high numbers. Like Teller Elementary, Bear Valley Middle School, and Northfield High, all at nearly 100%. Other schools have challenges, like Fairview Elementary, DCIS Middle School, and High School hover just around 50%. Missing kids may be facing tough challenges at home, like having to babysit and no internet. Making a connection with the disconnected is a challenge.
We all call. I call as principal. Our classified, our secretaries call. That no one's immune to calling. And like I said, we've made 1,200 phone calls home since April 6th and will continue to do so.
And some schools are now even doing home visits to try and get kids back to learning.
Even like our safety teams are saying, how can we use district vehicles and different ways to go visit homes and check in and make sure that, you know, the family is safe and has what they need.
Jeremy Hohola, 9 News.